I hear the train coming.
Have we seen the most emotional moment of your career?
I haven't seen a highlight reel of the what just went down.
I don't know where. I'm stuck in full suspense, and time keeps dragging on.
I don't give a shit what he said.
Shit!
Saving 5 match points. I thought he was done and dusted, but how can you count this guy out?
When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy. Don't ever play with guns.
Number 20.
We'll get through this somehow, will we?
His name is Roger Federer.
I am 41 years old. I've played more than 1,500 matches over 24 years. Tennis has treated me more generously than I ever would have dreamt. And now I must recognize when it is time to end my competitive career. The last 24 years on tour have been an incredible adventure. While it sometimes feels like it went by in 24 hours, it has also been so deep and magical that it seems as if I've already lived a full lifetime. I've had the immense fortune to play in front of you in over 40 different countries. I have laughed and cried, felt joy and pain, and most of all, I have felt incredibly alive. Through my travels, I've met many wonderful people who will remain friends for life. I would also like to thank my competitors on the court. I was lucky enough to play so many epic matches that I will never forget. We battled fairly, with passion and intensity, and I always tried my best to respect the history of the game. I feel extremely grateful. We pushed each other, and together we took tennis to new levels.
Deserves a lot of credit.
And to win against probably the best player ever in this sport, it's a dream for him.
In my opinion, the tennis level is the best of the history.
I can cry like Roger, it's just a shame I can't play like him.
When my love of tennis started, I was a ball kid in my hometown of Basel. I used to watch the players with a sense of wonder. They were like giants to me, and I began to dream. My dreams led me to work harder, and I started to believe in myself. Some success brought me confidence, and I was on my way to the most amazing journey that has led to this day. Finally, to the game of tennis, I love you and will never leave you.
What will be some of your sweetest and best moments and memories?
You think about first Wimbledon, match with Sampras at Wimbledon.
Champion will have to come from behind as Federer. Federer takes the set. Oh, he's missed it! Oh my! On the centre court of Wimbledon, he has played a magnificent match to defeat the seven times champion.
And it was this fourth round match at Wimbledon in 2001 which saw the changing of the guard in men's tennis and marked the start of Roger Federer's ascent to the throne.
It's out! And out goes the number one seed and the world number one. Great moment in the career of Roger Federer.
Thank you, Jimmy, and we are blessed to have a dry Friday for the beginning of championship weekend at Wimbledon. And on center court, Andy Roddick and Roger Federer. I've got that lightning inside me,
son of a god. And this is his next chance to show what he's really made of, because people have talked about him being a Grand Slam winner for years. And here's his chance.
Roger Federer is one of the most beautiful players I've seen in the last 10 years.
Federer come up with this special shot again.
And in this battle of nexts, it is the Swiss. His precision takes him to the finals. Roger Federer goes to his knees, this time as a Wimbledon champion.
Roger Federer, Wimbledon champion. You better get used to that.
I was always joking around when I was a boy. I'm going to win this. And now I have it. Thanks to everybody. Oh, it's great.
Congratulations, Roger Federer.
This is how legends are made, like a titan that's rising.
Roger Federer is the Tennis Masters Cup champion 2003. Federer goes to number two in the world and surely will be number one in the world next year.
I'll smile, what it takes to fool this town. I'll do it till the sun goes down and all through the night time.
I love
you. Yeah, I'll tell you why.
Tout à l'heure, il avait été puni.
He's one point away from not only the championship, but officially taking over the mantle as the best player in the world. Roger Federer joins the greats as an Australian Open winner.
No, it's just too good. Roger Federer, the winner here for the first time. We have a new champion of the Pacific Life Open. And a worthy one indeed. The world number one, playing just like the world number one.
Hiding out deep down. Yeah, I know, I've heard that they let you feel in sure. It's the only way to make friendships grow. But I'm too afraid now.
Yeah, himself on all surfaces now as the undisputed world number one.
You know, everybody says it's easier to win it the first time than to defend it. We'll see this.
First of all, I'd like to congratulate Roger. You're starting to become very, very annoying.
But which match are you the most proud of, and where you feel like you played the best tennis ever?
For me, special is the US Open Finals against Leighton Hewitt. For me, that match was perfect. I was on top of the world. World number one, showed the world that I was a deserving world number one at what level. And for me, felt like a perfect storm.
Just talk about domination of a top opponent.
He's done it, and look what it means to Roger Federer. The world number one claims his first US Open title, and in emphatic fashion it was as well.
Well, it's always something special to watch the emergence of an all-time great. We always knew he was great, but to produce three slam wins in one season, that is knocking on the door of greatest ever.
Federer's taking it to a new level at the moment in the game, and you know, that's what drives you, that's what motivates you to try and compete with the best players week in and week out.
Oh, Roger Federer. Federer, miraculous shot.
At
last, an emotion. The best player of the modern era, perhaps the best player of all time. We shall see.
It has
It's been a stirring contest tonight. It might be one point away from finishing. Federer eyes the final once more. Angels and skylines. Could they come any better on match point? Safin hangs in there. Five sets it will be.
Extremely happy and exhausted, but you know, what a pity for him. He played great before, but we'll see much more from him in the future.
Well, boxing has the weigh-in. Tennis has the somewhat awkward photo op the day before the match. This one certainly feels like a heavyweight match. Some would say that he has no fear of you either. Maybe he's too young to know better, but do you sense that this guy is not the least bit intimidated to play you in a Grand Slam semi?
Well, I have the feeling he looks up to me quite a bit, you know, so, but I don't think that will play any role in that match. We're going to play each other. We have a lot of respect for each other, and I think we're big admirers from one and the other's game. He's used to the big moments, and I always have the feeling that also in the big moments he plays his best as well, so I'll be expecting a really tough match.
That you predicted earlier this week would win between 7 and 10 slams in his career. That's a whole lot of hype.
This kid's gonna be a legend. A legend was born today. Roger Federer has an equal.
Game 7.
He is the winner and still the undisputed champion of Wimbledon. Three in a row for Roger Federer.
Well, it's all over. So title number 22 in a row.
He's really a fair player, and I really enjoy it every time, not just because I win.
You know, you might have to play him again. In a couple...
Roger Federer now holds three of the four major trophies in tennis.
He's done it.
Everyone's getting used to hearing it, but he's, you know, proven why he's the best player in the world, and he deserved it. This is three times in a row, so congratulations.
Oh, what a finish! Roger Federer has done it. He defends his title here in Miami.
Nadal is the winner in Monte Carlo in dramatic fashion.
Nadal handling the pressure just so much better than Federer.
He's done it. His fifth victory in six meetings with the world number one, and his third this season.
Well, we are just moments away from the top two players in the tennis world taking the court at Philippe Chatrier, Roger Federer, and Rafa Nadal to play for the French Open Championship.
Roger Federer gets a chance to go to the French Open when he won Australia and play Rafael Nadal, the best clay court player in the world. And let's face it, that's the way Federer wants it.
And this is his best service, and he's beaten Roger Federer all three times they've played in 06, including twice on clay.
There's one guy and only one guy that he'd prefer to see out there in center court Sunday.
He wants Nadal. I mean, he knows that Nadal owns him. He has, you know, this is his best surface, Roger Federer, and he knows that if he's going to beat Nadal, it's going to be on Sunday.
Loving this rivalry, I guess you're not really.
Now I like it again. But
Federer has
has the trifecta at the U.S. Open, his ninth Grand Slam title.
Is that of everybody around this court. He can't believe what's happening to him. And that is it. To hold that trophy aloft once more means more than anything to him.
Well, Roger, Andy Roddick came into this tournament with a lot of confidence. He'd played beautifully. He'd taken you out in an exhibition in Kooyong. He'd beat some great players en route to the semifinals, but you completely dismantled him out here tonight. And I have just one question. Well, I have a lot of questions, but the first one is, why'd you do it?
A fitting way to end it. It's the perfect 10 for Roger. Emotion overcomes him as he takes his 10th Grand Slam championship and his third in Australia.
Moment of inspiration from Federer. He's done it. The streak of 81 consecutive matches on clay has come to an end.
Beat or crack that streak of Nadal, that was a tough task. So and, I'm looking forward to the French Open now.
Still the undefeated champion at Roland Garros. And again, history denied the great Federer. Time.
Look, it was such a close match. I told Rafael at the net he deserved it as well. So I'm the lucky one today. So thanks.
If he really wants to win this tournament, he's got to have a look at his schedule and how he plays those smaller tournaments, potentially have some bad losses, trying to do some things to learn how to maybe one day get a win here at Roland Garros.
And it's just the one person, isn't it, that stands in his way. That's the most frustrating thing. He's not having to take the losses on clay against two or three others. It's this one person.
Unbelievable, stunning performance by Nadal.
And it is quite amazing that he's still only number two in the world. At the way that he's playing at this stage, I mean, it's phenomenal that he hasn't ever hit that number one spot. But based on today, what we've seen this clay court season, it might not be long.
Well, he's being held out of number one by a sporting genius in Roger Federer, but I think this is a very pivotal moment in Federer's career. I think he has to reassess things.
On the last 2 points.
The biggest heartbreak on a tennis court?
Probably Wimbledon 2008.
Yeah! There's a new man at the head of men's tennis.
First of all, can I just say thank you as a tennis player that you allowed us to be part of this amazing spectacle? I mean, is that any consolation?
A little bit. Thanks, John. No, it's tough. It's tough. It hurts.
This will be the biggest upset of the week as the world's number one Roger Federer has been defeated in three sets.
Well, here's a familiar face. Birthday today. 27 years of age, Roger Federer. 12-time Grand Slam champion. Ironically, he loses the world number one that he has held for over 230 weeks consecutively, an all-time record, the day after the Olympic tennis competition.
James Blake says thank you very much. First ever win for James Blake against Roger Federer.
Murray's done it. A huge win. The fourth time in six meetings that he's been able to beat the former world number one. It's the first time ever that he's failed to make it through the group stages at the Tennis Masters Cup.
Maybe I'll try later again. I don't know. God, it's killing me.
Time for these two great champions.
Nadal conquers Federer again in a major final.
By a mile. And here is Tommy Haas with a break point to leave him to serve for the match. Right, I mean, that's the shot he's been going for, missing. with regularity.
Is that courage?
Gavaltar.
That he's not playing his best tennis, yet he's still, Ted, found a way to dig deeper, perhaps deeper than we've ever seen him before, to get to this position. He's got to do it now. No. Greatest of all time if he wins this.
Oh, and there's Federer.
The French Open for the first time in his career, and in addition must surely be regarded now as the greatest male player of all time.
Am I the greatest of all time? We don't know, but I definitely have many things going for me because I've now finally won in all four Grand Slams, and I'm particularly happy reaching, you know, to Pete's 14. I'm sure he's watching, so hey Pete, and I'm sure I'll see you soon.
Well, he's closing in on what he so desires, which is that 15th Grand Slam victory and a sixth Wimbledon that would break a tie with him.
I'm not getting that many tough questions anymore, you know, because the Paris question is answered, the 15 is answered.
And who do you want a rematch with?
Maybe Del Potro, US Open final in 2009.
Juan Martín Del Potro, the 2009 US Open champion.
He proves again. He is the master.
He is the king. He is the master. He is the Australian Open champion of 2010. He is Roger Federer of Switzerland.
The Federer streak has finally ended. Robin Soderling takes out the defending champ.
The sixth time on the court he cherishes the most. Federer is beaten.
Novak Djokovic goes to the final of the US Open. Roger Federer deeply disappointed.
Perhaps a point away from a victory that could signal the beginning of the shift atop men's tennis.
And this would be the biggest win of his career, I believe, if he could do what seemed to be the impossible. Beat Rafa Nadal in the finals of French Open on clay.
Federer trying to finish it there with real style.
That's the first one that Nadal's ended in style.
Last time Federer had a two-set lead and lost. I wonder if that's ever happened in a Grand Slam. Oh, well, Songa's looking to turn this into a muscle match. And nobody's beating Songa in a muscle match. Phenomenal from Songa. We're going the distance here. That's long.
He hasn't won a major this year. The perception is he's really kind of on the backside of his career.
Two match points. Here
beast. What a rally from two sets down against the great Roger Federer.
Ribbons from the sea.
Oh my
God.
Still, Federer has only beaten him in a major at Wimbledon.
Something in the way, yeah. Something in the way.
So the obituaries are going to be written for Federer's career after this one. Djokovic, a straight sets winner over Roger Federer here at the French Open.
I mean, Djokovic was a bit tired today, but Federer was exhausted. The question to Mark and Jim is, he's down physically because he's going to be 31, or is he still that strong, as as Djokovic, Nadal, and those players?
Let's not write him off. Let's enjoy Roger Federer while we still can, because eventually time will catch him. I mean, eventually, I think he's got another, realistically, 2 years before he does start to lose a little foot speed, and that will be fatal against these players. But I think he still has another eight majors where he can make hay, and if he stays in there long enough, maybe he gets another one. I'd love to see him win another one. I mean, I'm as big a Roger Federer fan as you're going to get. He's been so good for our sport, a class champion all the way.
Outrageous. The rally of the match, one of the rallies of the tournament. It is an ace. And again, the single digit. Two gladiators who've given us the match of the tournament, if not the match of the year.
I can feel the pressure. Yeah, I know the pain and the hurt. I've been climbing up all these mountains for so long. And I've been building up all these kingdoms for so long. I will not run when destiny comes. I dip in my hand and go. It's good to be good.
Now I have a chance at world number one and at the title again all at once, so it's a big match for me, and I hope I can, you know, keep my nerves. I'm sure I can.
More important to you? You know, you're just going to beat Roger, not Roger Federer, I should say, Pete Sampras's record of 286 weeks as world number one. You've won seven Wimbledons. You know, what keeps you motivated? You've got two kids, a lovely wife.
Right.
What drives you to do all these records and continue playing so well?
So for me, I think I'm aware of how lucky I have become, and I am today playing on center court. Every match I do play, I have such amazing crowd support everywhere I do go, that is for me reason enough to be motivated. And then the family aspect, that my wife's willing to do all the sacrifice, that the kids are happy on tour, that we make it work. It's quite magical. And this was not just a big moment in my career, but in my life actually. And that's where, you know, you feel like maybe you want to do more, but who knows what's going to happen next few years. But I'm excited.
It's gonna be
first set, a bagel for Roger Federer.
What a season Roger Federer is putting together.
in his 32nd year on Earth. How must it feel for this man going into the U.S. Open, which he's also won 5 times?
And Roger Federer.
How's that reception, Doug?
Well, you know, it's amazing when you're the best. Normally people cheer against the best. That's one of the things about Federer. He gets everybody all over the world because he's such a great ambassador, but he's such a great just person in general. Yeah. He does everything.
Well, that's exactly what I was going to say. Is, you know, people love Federer because he's the best, and he's still so grounded and so genuine.
And he handles pressure. The pressure.
Well,
of
you can't have his record without being able to handle pressure.
Celebrity. He's a rock star, basically. He's got.
Remember, the number one seed hasn't lost before the semifinals in 11 years. And on break point, Berdych pulls out an unbelievable shot. Tomas Berdych, welcome to the semifinals of the U.S. Open.
And we finished the day off with this.
No one could believe that Federer was down 2 sets to love. When he got that third set, everyone in the building thought he was going 5 for the win.
I don't go into with a mindset in it that I've never lost him in slams. He's beaten me so many times. He's beaten me more than I think I have beaten him. So, I mean, but of course I'm happy you give me the positive news and it's good vibe. And
that's good. That's ridiculous.
Federer still hitting out. He shot Andy a look after that point.
Interesting.
I haven't seen this between these two.
I've never seen Federer that ticked off at an opponent ever.
Set love and now serves for this semifinal at 6-5. And he will take everything Federer has now to hang on. He's really in deep trouble.
That's a smart move in this game. He pays the price.
Federer now a streak of 6 hardcourt majors that he hasn't won. One in the last 9.
What an end to the day here at Wimbledon. The defending champion is out.
And it's done. Tommy Robredo has taken out Roger Federer.
For the first time in his life, Federer's doubting himself.
Clearly very disappointed, you know, not to come through with the win. After the chance in the second set and sort of a lot of regrets here now.
Roger's going to walk away from the set and go, kind of, what happened? Wow.
This is not for me, this is for them. I've won enough in my career that I don't need this to complete my everything, you know, ticking off the box. So I'm just happy for everybody else, and I'm happy we can live a great tennis historic moment in our country.
He's made it! Oh, and he's through an astonishing final shot.
Appearances. Do you think Djokovic will be as dominant or even more dominant than you have been, having him no great opponents in the future?
Okay, but you gotta be careful how you phrase the question. Don't want to be rude to the other players, because you gotta face them. I don't have to face them. Yeah, I don't ask them stupid questions like that.
I know. Something went wrong. Don't know what. Can't believe it. A double fault twice. Unexplainable for me, really. Very sad about that, and angry really at myself, because never should I allow him to get out of that set that easily.
Oh, it's good. Federer down. And it's not often you see Roger Federer lying prone on center court. I don't know if I've ever seen
it. I'm not thinking about this might be my last Wimbledon. And yes, I hope to be back on center court, to be very clear for you.
Roger Federer has announced that he will not compete at the Rio Olympics and miss the rest of 2016 in order to treat an injury.
He has turned back the clock.
Time to soldier up, get ready for war. They with sweat and blood.
Now the legend writes another chapter.
It's gonna take everything you got. I'm coming with a vengeance.
Championship points. Can you believe us? Hawkeye decides the outcome.
Der 18. Grand Slam-Titel für Federer.
I'm happy. I'm
happy for you. I would have been happy to lose too, to be honest. The comeback was perfect as it was. Tennis is a tough sport. There's no draws, but if there was going to be one, I would have been very happy to accept the draw tonight and share it with Rafa, really. The worst I ever felt was on the grass court season because I knew my knee wasn't well. And that's where I got super frustrated just shortly before Wimbledon. When the tournament was over and I just realized that knee was not going to get better right now and I was going to miss the Olympics, US Open, everything was gone. I mean, I was sad, you know, of course I was. So to be here right now, it's great.
Enjoy the moment.
Yeah, well,
you earned it, man.
Yep. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Well done. Much.
Better than me today and 5 years ago, 10 years ago, always was better than me.
Roger Federer
makes it 5 in Indian Wells.
I would like to congratulate Roger. He's laughing, he's an asshole, but it's okay.
It's like, feels like old times, you know, we're playing each other every week now. Can't get enough of each other, but
Roger Federer completes the sunshine double. He wins in Miami. It's a 2017 that surely even he couldn't have dreamed of.
Just genius.
A missing two.
Again, Stenemach.
A masterpiece by the master. Wimbledon title for Roger Federer.
Fitting that it was ace number 8 in this final match to bring him his 8th championship.
He won here last in 2012. And to go so long without a Grand Slam title, you know, it would be very easy to walk away.
Very easy. I'm sure he's the first one to admit that he had serious doubts whether he can win one more, you know, let alone two more. And again, the question is ultimately, how much do you love your sport, how much you love to compete, how much you love the lifestyle, and if that's in place, then the results will come. Obviously, it's all based on a healthy body, but it's really what he loves doing.
Roger Federer is the Shanghai Rolex Masters champion for a second time. He's got it! It's game on! Oh, you've got to be kidding me!
That's big time tennis.
That
super scintillating and sensational six for Federer down under. My team.
I love you guys. Thank you.
Roger Federer rewrites the tennis history books in Rotterdam. He becomes the oldest man ever to top the ATP rankings.
Thank you.
When did you feel you lost control over the match? Somewhere in the third set or maybe later?
Maybe. Honestly, I'm not sure. I guess there was definitely a moment at some point. You know, is it missing match points? Is it getting broken at 5-all after that? I'm not sure.
Here, it's a couple of match points for Kevin Anderson. What a remarkable comeback. Federer departs this year's Wimbledon at the quarterfinal stage.
Yeah, of course, the goal is to come here back here next year, you know. I wouldn't call it unfinished business, you know. I feel like I did a good business here in the past already. So I'm all right, you know. Just disappointed now.
This is a changing of the guards on court at the end. Do you see it that way?
I've heard of that story the last 10 years, so from that standpoint, nothing new there.
He does that to anybody, you know, on the clay. He makes you feel uncomfortable. The way he defends the court and plays on clay, there's nobody who even plays remotely close to him.
After a three-year absence, Federer made a return to Roland Garros, eventually losing to Rafael Nadal in the semi-finals. But he returned to winning ways on the grass courts of Halle to claim his 102nd career title.
When you talk about him winning one more, people say, well, it'll be Wimbledon. If he wins, it's going to be Wimbledon. He's got eight there. He's going to add to it there. So he needs a little bit of fortune, a little bit of luck in the early stages of the draw. You wonder if someone with that many titles, that much success, feels the pressure, but they are competitive beasts. They want to win, and they love winning Wimbledon.
Thank you.
Bat away. What a contest. Roger Federer, 37 years of age. He's into his 12th Wimbledon final.
Stars are aligned right now. So from that standpoint, I can go into that match very confidently.
Served 56 aces coming into this match. He's served 22 so far against possibly the greatest returner.
And he's got two match points here, Roger Federer. He has come back from the brink in this match.
Roger makes that first serve. It is an ace. Probably a quarter of an inch, maybe.
I was very close to losing.
One shot, I guess. So don't know which one to pick. Your choice.
Two championship points.
Thank you.
Reminds me of the semi-final, I think, at the US Open when Federer had 40-15 serving.
It hurts, but it's fine. It could be worse, it could be fine.
That backhand down the line.
Back of your battle with Roger, what one sort of comes to mind?
2019, sorry, Roger. Finals.
What happened? I blocked it out.
And that's it. On a massive miss hit, Wimbledon number 5 for the Serbian superstar. What a treat this has been.
I will try to forget.
Equally, your heart has to go out to Roger Federer. Somebody at the end of all this had to lose, and it could not be more painful, really. At nearly 38 years of age, the chance for a 9th Wimbledon title, that 21st crown that might have kept him ahead of the rest when they all hang up their rackets. How's he going to deal with this now, Carthy, do you think?
I think he's going to find this one really tough to get over. And I think we saw that in his face, in the interview afterwards, in the reaction that he gave. Just getting to this final at Wimbledon means so much. And I think there was a point a few years ago where we thought he was going to definitely not be overtaken in the Grand Slam titles. But we are all now starting to realise that Djokovic could quite easily overtake him, and Roger Federer clearly knows that as well, and he wants that record. Yeah. So it's really tough for him.
Oh, yes! Dimitrov finds a way to steal the point. From under Federer is nice.
Today was horrible, you know, to go through what I did. Nice entrance, nice send-off, and in between, it's one to forget. Because you know you have a 3% chance to win.
Thank you.
Djokovic dominates Federer.
You were obviously limited in your movement tonight, but knowing what the injury is yourself, how long do you think it'll be before you're 100% again?
Don't know. My feeling is rather quickly.
Tennis legend Roger Federer will miss the rest of the 2020 season. He's had a second surgery on his right knee.
Roger Federer has withdrawn from Roland Garros this year.
It was tough, you know, the last few games, obviously, as you can feel that you're not coming back from it.
Well, a lot of emotions watching Federer leave the court because you're not sure if this is it.
I've been doing a lot of checks with the doctors as well on my knee, getting all the information as I hurt myself further during the grass court season and Wimbledon, and it's just not the way to go forward. So unfortunately, they told me for the medium to long term, to feel better, I will need surgery.
Nice signs from those guys at the end of the match.
Oh, what a match!
So it's the day that tennis and everybody has been dreading, the end of Roger Federer's tennis career. And Roger, I've covered a lot of retirements and there's always a lot of tears, but you seem quite at peace with your decision. How hard was it to make? How did you make it?
This weekend's going to be one of the probably toughest moments that tennis have to live for the last, for his history. You know, Mr. Roger Federer have to say goodbye.
Today,
it's a sad day for tennis, but just sport in general. But you know, Roger's legacy will live forever. That's for sure.
In a personal way, I've been very, very, very sad news and a tough day.
I was lucky to get to compete against him in some of the biggest matches, in the biggest tournaments, on the biggest stages in our sport. It's a sad, sad day.
He was the greatest of that time.
I'm thankful to have shared some of the biggest stages with Roger.
We've come to the end of it all, you know, and it's been a wonderful moment. You look back at all the great things we have achieved together, and that it's okay to step away.
Please welcome Roger Federer and Rafael Nadal.
Important part of my life, it's living with him.
What could I say? Close am I to losing you? Tonight
last farewell.
It was never supposed to be that way. It's just happy to play tennis and spend time with my friends, really. And it didn't end here, so it's been a perfect journey. I would do it all over again.
Passed away the year before you won your first slam at Wimbledon, obviously. What do you think he would have thought to see you here now with 20 Grand Slams? It's okay. I'm sorry.
I hope he would be proud. I guess he didn't want me to be a wasted talent, so I guess it was somewhat of a wake-up call for me when he passed away, and I really started to train hard.
Is there anything you'd like to say about him in context of where you're at in your life right now?
I think what I would like to say is that I've been incredibly fortunate to having had the right people at the right time, the right coaches at the right time. I mean, sure, you could argue I made those decisions, but I also got lucky along the way.